Yo, what is up, everyone? Welcome to another stream. Today, we're watching the Habs go against the Senators. Woo! Reason for the title is that basically everyone, I've heard lots of Sens fans say that these teams are rivals. Even though I guess it's somewhat accurate, but not really. They just be mad that Jack Eye screwed up like so many of their players in the preseason. And darn, it's only national broadcasts here. So we'll have to deal with the national broadcast. So, last 10 records for the Habs and Senators. Habs is 5 wins, 4 loss, 1 overtime loss. Senators is 6 wins, 3 loss, and 1 overtime loss. Their streak is on a 2-game winning streak. Montreal's on a 1-game winning streak. Power play percentage is 14.4 for Montreal, putting them in 30th. Ottawa is 27.4, putting them in 6th. Penalty kill is 80.8%, putting them 10th. 78.6 for Ottawa, putting them 17th. Faceoff percentage is 51.1% for Montreal, putting 12, 53.6 for Ottawa, putting them in 4th, and that, and then goals for games played, it is a 2.86 for Montreal and a 3.07 for Ottawa. And then for goals against per games played, it's a 3.46 for Montreal, putting them in 3rd. And then for Ottawa, it's a 3.18, putting them at 18th. The last 5 games, the points, the player with the most points for Montreal is Nick Suzuki with 4, and then Drake Batherson with 7. Goals is Josh Anderson with 3, and then Thomas Chabot with 3. Except Chabot didn't score what I want him to in that Tim Hortons thing. So, and then for assists, it's Matheson with 4, and then Batherson with 5. Matheson's not even there. That's how you know how things have been. Plus minus is Doc with 3, and then Chabot with a 1. Montembeau will be going on the starting for the Habs, from what I've heard on Habs Twitter. And I'm not sure for Senators. This is Montreal and Ottawa's first game of the season. And I found the, I just got the notification for the lineup, so I'm about to pull that up real quick. Hopefully you don't hear me breathing a lot. So first line from Montreal is Caulfield, Suzuki, Doc. That's basically their best line in ages. Other than that, Tatar, Gallagher, and Deneau. Then their second line is Slavkovsky, Evans, and Anderson. Third line is Dadonov, Dvorak, Kaufman. And then last, fourth line is Pezzetta, Drouin, and Armia. Defenders are Edmondson, Gouley, Harris, Kovacevic, Honda Civic, and then last is Jack Eye Wideman. This is for goalies, is Montembeau, as mentioned. Alrighty. Is the game started yet? No. So, music I'm having played right now is like the 140 minutes of winter Nintendo music mix in 2019. Let's go. Let's go. Let's see if I'm able to find a 2022 version of that, if it's been released yet. Hasn't released one of it yet. Okay. There's a preview of it, but there's nothing other than that. But there's a 2021 version. There you go. You need to just be chilling. Stream is still up, so that's epic. The game is starting, but it's like... it's like the preview promo, like the pregame stuff. So during the intermissions today, I'll just be playing that Be Right Back video. But I'll actually be here once the intermission restarts, and not the intermission, the game restarts. Hopefully the mic audio is way better. I got a new headset, and I also I looked into some YouTube videos for what's the best settings on OBS. So if it's shit, then I blame the YouTube video. Oh yeah, and today I won't need to worry about my food delivery app because I purposely made my shift end at 7 so I can watch the game and not be worried. TellJe Studios live, what? Impossible. TellJe Studios is never live. Alright, I just got a notification saying ball match. So I'm assuming the game is starting. For real this time. Why is the audio so long?
Meanwhile, for the Ottawa Senators, Cam Talbot stopped all 32 shots he faced, earning his first shutout with Ottawa on Monday. And it's first since April 19th, when he was with Minnesota, when he blanked the Montreal Canadiens. Injuries on both sides tonight, but the depth is what will show for these two clubs in a fired-up building. It always is when the Canadiens are in town in Ottawa, as many fans make the trek over the border for this one. Jake Evans and Shane Pinto line up at center, and away we go on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey on Sportsnet.
All right, let's watch this game. We are started.
Josh Anderson rolled it into the Ottawa zone. Jake Sanderson back on the puck. They'll feed it across for DeBrincat and back for Sanderson. Fans already starting off with the chanting for both teams as Sanderson will get it.
Oh boy. And we're already lying. Woo!
Edmondson knocks it back out. Now it is dumped in, and Edmondson goes back to get it. In comes Batherson, so we'll move it for Juraj Slafkovský. Slafkovský trying to get away from the forecheck of Derek Brassard. Now Kaden Gooley trying to shake off Brassard as he knocks it off his stick. Brassard steps into the spot for Tim Stützle tonight on that top line with Tkachuk. And Claude Giroux, as Tkachuk goes in and finishes his check on Cooley, as Giroux tried to get it across for Broussard, and it was tipped away. Here's Edmondson up to Kirby Dock. feeds it down for Cole Caulfield with a shot. And that one sails just wide as Talbot may have got a piece of it.
All right, come on, Montreal. Let's actually, like, start this game with a goal and show them who's boss. Even though I want Bedard. See, a perfect Montreal game is basically Montreal scoring a lot, but they still manage to lose. I feel like if we still had a prime Carey Price, this team could easily be a contender. Like, we need consistent goaltending is one of the big problems of this team. Yeah, there's time where, like, Jake Allen can be, like, god mode. And then there's times where he's just, like, lets in, like, six fucking goals. And same with Montembeau. The only thing with Montembeau, though, is that he's a younger goaltender, so it's, like, easier to forgive him.
The Canadiens back as Weidman gets it up for Drouin. Now he'll send it back to Arbor Jacki. Weidman, watched by Shane Pinto. Now it is Evans that's got it. Here comes Jake Evans. Flips it into the corner. Shabbat goes after it. Evans right on him as Nikita Zaitsev's on the puck. He'll play it forward, and that'll make it out back to the Canadiens line. Harris is on it.
All right, come on.
Trying to flip it in front. Bouncing puck. Slavkovsky will knock it away. Evans gets it up for Anderson. Makes a save. Batherson through center for Pinto.
All righty, we've disconnected once.
3.5 minutes gone here in the opening period without a whistle yet. Anderson lays it off for Evans. And he'll cross the red line and tough it in. Takes Anderson back on it. Works it up for Tkachuk. Over to Claude Giroux. Means the red line, tucks it in, and went off the stick of Edmondson. Baltimore's out of the net. Played it around the boards. It gets to the point. Havanek trying to hold the zone. Taken away. Cole Caulfield with it. He's got Suzuki going.
Ooh. Ooh. My God.
He holds on as we get our
almost got the first goal.
Certainly has come ready to play. The Ottawa Senators might be a bit asleep here as the pace of this period.
The stream has been going like this, and then this
chance right there. Harris walks in. That one might have glanced off the crossbar, and then this breakaway pass from Harris to Anderson. He tries to go upstairs on the short side, and then not to be outdone again. Caulfield coming down the offside, tries to hit the short corner, but Talbot will have nothing to do with that. He's been really good of late. Back-to-back wins, has a shutout in there. Only two goals on his last 62 shots on net. And it's a good thing he was ready to start this one. It's at zero still. And there's Jacob Lucchini making his NHL debut, wearing number 36 for the Ottawa Senators from Trail BC.
Yeah, his helmet off. Run. Get out of there, bud. It'll come free forever. Or else there'll be a penalty.
As Ottawa gets the change. Well, proud moment for the kid from Trail BC. And his mom, John, and Sandy back home watching. This one couldn't get out here. It's unfortunate. It takes a village, and 27 years old, it certainly took a while, but nonetheless, I'm sure feels pretty good to get out there and get that first shift under your belt. Now here's Mike Hoffman with it. Beats it across for Dadanoff. Flipped to the goal and gloved by Talbot. Well, I think Holden got a stick on that. He didn't get much wood on it, as we see Kastelic on the bench.
Oh shit, my graphics aren't updated.
For sure. And Jacki doesn't mind the hard contact. Two big boys going at it here.
Lots of poundage trying to get an advantage as they go into the corner fighting for a loose puck. The one thing the Senators will have to keep an eye on here is Montreal's transition game. It's one thing they've really improved at. They're really good at it. They get from their end to your end awfully quick. We've seen a couple of good scoring chances already against Ottawa. They'll have to tighten up the neutral zone, try to slow Montreal down a little bit.
Edmondson backs it ahead for Kadanoff. Played it across and it's snapped towards it. It's a stick there. Pranstrom got it away.
Alrighty, that's the one.
Giroux tries to tip it out. And they will clear it as Dvorak has got it at center.
And then there's two.
Now it's Edmondson. He'll dump it in. Got away from Talbot back in the net. Dvorak goes after it along the boards. Tangled up with Zaitsev. Armia comes in to try and jar the puck loose. Joel Armia. Knocked it onto the boards for Dvorak. Now it comes loose and it's flipped out by Derek Brassard. And that hits someone on the Ottawa bench and we'll get a whistle.
It'll all come all the way back to the left of Talbot. And there was some talk that Cole Caulfield wasn't going to be in this game tonight, possibly. He took a hit from Trevor Lewis. And you'll see the collision right here.
Yeah, Caulfield got hit hard and then had to go for concussion.
The first thing you do is you grab the head. Not only does the spotter see that, but everyone sees that. And the Montreal Canadiens doctors are saying, no, they shut him down in that game. They wanted to evaluate him some more. They did that. They allowed him to play in this game. And he looks pretty good to me. Three shots thus far in the early parts of this first period.
Montebourg out of the net.
Yeah, if the you may give the stream like three tries and then if three strikes and if it doesn't like if it keeps on disconnecting then I'll just shut off the stream and then post the recording after.
Wyman will skate away from that as Canadians bring it out. Here comes Pizzetta. Got to the line and flipped it in.
Then you can see this edited highlight, like the highlights of this stream on the Hockey Donkey channel. And then the VOD will be posted on TellJe Studios too.
Now the Brinkett, back for Pinto, cut off by Kovacevic. Here's Pinto centers in front. Great chance for the break in.
Pinto for off.
Pinto has got it again. Good play by Kovacevic to block the pass. Harris in the corner, tangled up with Shane Pinto. Anderson waiting in front. Canadians clear it. Holden's got it back at center.
What a great opportunity for DeBrincat to open up the scoring in this game. Senators, unfortunately, do not even have a shot on net yet, although they have been around the net, especially DeBrincat. That was a pretty good chance.
He had two power play goals against Anaheim and riding that six-game point streak with 7 points for DeBrincat. Now Brandstrom after the puck. He'll knock it around for Holden. Holden off the boards to center. Kachuk works it free, and it's played in by Derek Brassard. Jake Evans got it around, and then Kachuk is physical on Kaden Gooley and knocked him off stride. Here's Slavkovsky.
All right, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Evans on net.
Bruh.
By Talbot, rebound is off the
so close.
Center.
Well, they know who Kaden Gooley is. They know the amount of minutes he plays and how important he is to the Montreal Canadiens. And that's the second hit that Brady Kachuk has delivered on Gooley in that corner. They're going to make sure they make
it. Ooh, are we going to see a fight tonight?
Ottawa out hitting Montreal 10-5 so far in the game.
Jack Eye's been like their number one target because of the preseason action.
Now it is picked up as Kastelic tries to go to the net with it. Watson after it throws it off the outside of the goal. There's Lucchini back in the net. Knocked down by Edmondson. He's got to his feet. He's got it down. Dropped it off for Watson. Austin Watson to the point for Shabbat. Dumps it in. Picked up by Kastelic behind the goal. Turns away from Kaden Gooley. Feeds it up high for Shabbat. Shabbat slides it back across. Thrown towards the net by Kastelic.
There's people in the background waving their flags. And I'd be annoyed if I was the people above them.
Here's Suzuki on it.
Like sing in the row behind above them because like honestly I'm trying to watch the game here. That's what I'd be saying. Like they had it waving for like a solid like 20 seconds.
Left it for Dvorak. Played for Hoffman. Got to the line. Broken up by Dylan Gambrell. And that will get the whistle and the penalty. Thomas Chabot will get called for roughing, and the Canadians will get the opening power.
Alrighty, let's do this. No advertisement, no. Bro, they be playing advertisements on my graphics here. What the fuck? Alrighty, so now we just be chilling until it restarts. Yeah, Wi-Fi's been an issue. Not that kind, but my Wi-Fi. And you seen the frames keeps on dropping, and you just see me like being probably on your on the end of like the viewers. You hear me talking, and then it goes that. It's probably what you hear. But yeah. Because of that, I've just been more focused on the editing of stuff and recording. So, at least compensate. But yeah. Hopefully the Wi-Fi gets sorted out soon. I've been meaning to call the internet provider and be like, what the heck's going on? But yeah, I guess we'll see what happens. Will TellJe ever combat his Wi-Fi issue, or will he forever be a non-streamer?
For 2 minutes or less. The Canadiens' power play is gone without a goal in each of their last four games, are on an 0-for-17 run.
Don't worry, we're just tanking. That's why their power play's been bad.
To center, and he drops it back as Cole Caulfield will catch it. Stays it to the line for Slavkovsky. Back to Caulfield in the corner. Trying to get it up front. Slavkovsky feeds it over to Doc. Back to the point.
Doc, my dude, you could have scored it right there.
Down to Slavkovsky. Up high to the point. Drouin. Had to settle the puck down. Now he got it for Doc here. Suzuki back for Drouin.
Shoot it. Your mom told you to shoot it more, so shoot it more.
Two games they had Hoffman on that point spot. They used five forwards, the Montreal Canadiens, with Drouin back in the lineup, and his skill sets, they'll put him on the back.
Caulfield on it at center. Played it up for Suzuki. Back to Caulfield. Going to the net.
Oh! Beat!
And Saitsev's got it, and he'll clear it down the ice.
Fucking put Gouley in that quarterback's position.
The first game with seven or more power play opportunities and no power play goals since the 2015-16 season when they went 0-for-7 against, you guessed it, the Ottawa Senators.
And then on the other one, Jack Eye.
Pass, broken up, and Kelly clears it.
Like, dude.
That's been a bit of a problem for them for a good part of the season, but as of late, last three games, they've had three clean slates, and over the last five games, running at about 86%, so they've been a little bit sharper of late. Montreal's power play not so good, and kind of the way it's been going here so far.
Three games this year, the Canadians have had six or more power plays.
I'd rather watch, paint dry than this power play.
Down the wing, trying to backhand it towards an edit with block. Down it off, believe it for Hoffman.
Like, why have Hoffman there? Put Gouley.
One shot for Montreal on the power play. And Ottawa kills.
Bruh.
Oh, I don't think this is going to be the last power play we'll see tonight. Montreal ranks 29th. In penalties, the Senators 27th. Both teams have taken a lot of penalties, so I'm sure we'll see more power plays.
Dvorak through center, off for Evans, slides it over to Hoffman. Hoffman in the corner, being watched by Giroux. Comes around for Edmondson. Plays it all the way back to the point. Harris is there to get it. Down to the corner for Hoffman. Broke it up by Giroux. Brady Tkachuk will clear it out. And Edmondson backs up with it. Gets it up ahead for Dvorak. Through center for Harris. Out of the wing, Pezzetta goes after it, but Thomas Chabot will control it. Gets away from Pezzetta. Turned over, though, inside.
All right, come on, let's go.
Dvorak's on it.
Dvorak. Oh!
Lost his stick on the play as well. So the power play draws nothing. Ottawa still looking for their first shot. Scoreless on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey.
Oh, TellJe Studios is live again. Wow, I thought you just went like, no, that's just my thing dying. Alright. Uno dos. Alrighty, one more time. If it goes down one more time, this is just becoming a recording. Then you'll be able to get to see the stream, the VOD. You'll get to see the VOD whenever I upload it. So, probably because of Twitch rules tomorrow. Then I'll be editing it. Turning it more of a highlight reel. Like, whenever I finish editing, I have to edit this week's Nahami remastered video still, so. And I have a other project I got to edit, so. We'll see. We'll see how long that takes.
Different. Tom on the bench looked even the conversation there with Jonathan Drouin. Even in Vancouver last week when they blew a four-goal lead, didn't let his emotions sway. And again, didn't get much out of that opening power play, but his emotions have remained in check early on here tonight as well.
Yeah, my breathing was just caught right there.
Well, the next night in Seattle, they blew a lead again, but found a way to come back. And what he said was, this is how our team's going to learn. We have to go through things. And then we'll learn how to win. And when we learn how to win, we'll win more often, more consistently. It's about how you deliver the message. And that's the key part for a guy like Marty St. Louis. He delivers the message to his guys the way that they understand it, they get it, and they trust him.
Travis Hamonic with the first shot on net of the game for the Ottawa Senators. Took about 12 and a half minutes to get it. Now here's Suzuki as he'll play it into the Ottawa zone. Wrong side of center, and that'll be an icing call.
Download the app and see for yourself why Bet365 is the world's favorite sports book.
Kirby Dock.
My God, I'm excited to get my contact lenses. One of these problems when I go record is you see the reflection.
Suzuki did feather it through. And then it went down.
So you don't actually get to see my freaking eyes.
He thought he was going to go offside, but Suzuki knew he was there.
Caulfield dumps it in, comes off the boards in front of the net, cleared away by Zaitsev. Nick Suzuki, back to the net, Zaitsev will put it out of play, but did it hit the glass first? Yes, it did, and we'll have a face-off in the Ottawa zone.
Well, a big part of the Senators and kind of getting things turned around.
I know.
4 points behind the Montreal Canadiens, a couple points behind the Sabres.
The one thing I'm probably going to have to get used to, though, is putting behind those contact lenses in my eye. It's probably going to be a learning curve.
Yes,
and not feel, it's going to feel weird, but it's definitely going to be better wearing glasses.
Nine goals their last three games, they found a way to be 2-0-1. So not just trying to outscore you, they want to defend better, get better goaltending, be systematically better. So that's the improvements for the Ottawa Senators.
They're two healthy goalies. Makes a big difference for Ottawa. Here's Evans in on the wing, checked by Chabot. Zaitsev.
We'll play it up, and that one got away from Parker Kelly, and that'll
we'll get to see no glasses, TellJe.
When you got to leapfrog a bunch of teams and you're a bunch of points behind, you got to catch up. And even though December has been really good for the Ottawa Senators, 4-1-1, and November was a tough stretch. So yeah, it's a lot of points to make up, and you haven't moved a lot in the standings, but you're starting to smell the guys in front of you. You're starting to get a little bit closer.
Starting to smell the guys in front of you. Okay.
And win a game like this. This is the first time they're playing the Canadiens this year. You only get four cracks at them, and this is a team that's in front of you. So these are big points, even though it's still fairly
early. You guys can go ahead and win against us.
Hoffman won the draw.
We need Bedard.
And then you flip it on the other, you turn it over to Montreal, and the expectations for the Montreal Canadiens, they weren't up there, their fan base, and everyone knew this is a big, rebuild. They're getting things turned around here in Montreal, going to do it the right way. But the one thing the Canadiens have done
getting Bedard.
Point the season, and that's why
or one of the top five guys at least. That's what I want. After this draft, we can start actually like getting veterans that are actually good. Then boom. And we'll need to get a good goaltender as well. Well, sorry, not a good goaltender, a consistent goaltender.
Jack guy gets a few extra shots in before he heads to the box. So the Ottawa Senators.
What I mean, good veterans, I mean, not Mike Hoffman. Would you consider Armia a veteran?
This period brought to you by Scotiabank.
No.
See how we're making.
I forgot how old Armia is. Quickly check that. Yol Armia. He is 29 years, yeah. He is a veteran. Yes, you could call him a veteran. Should have traded him in 2019, 2020. And he's a first rounder too. Oof. Another bus. Another Finland bus. I mean, it's not Montreal that picked him, but so.
Shabbat gifted his teammate four bottles of wine and a day at the spa with the missus. Now, Hamannik said he was able to lap it off soon after anyways. So, not bad compensation, Johnny.
No, that's not.
Bruh, that guy, the Ottawa player, freaking hit. Slash his own player on the bench. Wait, was there a fight? We missed out on Jack Eye doing something. SMH Sportsnet.
Power play running at 32.4% over their last 17 games, going 22-68. Canadians are on it. They'll clear it here.
Yeah, it's a good thing he was wearing his visor. You never know when someone's going to take a swing at you. Sometimes it's your own teammate.
He did joke. He's like, well, I wasn't worried about my
camera. Bro, that one, the camera was white balance, was warm, too warm.
is Shabbat. Into the corner. Slides it off for Kachuk. Back to the point.
Like the screen was yellow.
Giroux. Hanging on to it. Has a look around. Shabbat to Giroux. Slides it down low. Kachuk in tight. Flipped it towards an end. Scramble for it. Another penalty.
There's a set white balance button for
Ottawa. It'll be a high sticking call and end the power play.
I know there is, because I've done camera work for hockey teams, and if they have similar cameras, then there should be that set white balance. All cameras have like set white balance.
Go over and discuss this over at the penalty box.
Or color temperature.
Montreal player got hit with his own player's stick. There's no penalty on the play.
And that's just great that the referees get together and have a look at this and talk about it. And you'll see it right here as there's the swing, and it's Armia's stick that catches Joel Edmondson.
Yeah.
And right there. And that's just good on the referees to get together. Sometimes things are happening so fast down there. Sticks are up in the air, swinging at loose pucks, and good that they got it right.
How many bottles of wine is that one worth?
Here's Shabbat. Laying it out for DeBrincat, back to Shabbat.
The commentator was just like, shut Shabbat the fuck up.
He's on DeBrincat, with the stick in the air, he was waiting for it, now down low.
Back ooh, that dive.
Anderson shoots, that one missed. Giroux picks it up on the boards. Will Giroux, down and tight for Kachuk, back to Giroux in the corner.
That dive though.
Kachuk again, for Giroux. To the point for Shabbat, played over to DeBrincat, fires, that goes wide, Giroux waiting for it. 12
that
seconds
dive,
to go on the power play. Shabbat, pass for DeBrincat, back to Shabbat. Shabbat to DeBrincat, fires, and it's blocked by Kaden Gooley. Evans going after it.
All right, come on, guys, what the, no!
Kachuk was there, swung it around the boards, but it's...
4 more minutes remaining.
Sanderson will take it back for Ottawa. Sanderson down the wing. Watch closely in the corner.
Low key hoping this pair was going to be more exciting.
Harris after it. Hit by Pinto. Broussard has got it. Throws it towards the net.
Bro, these ads are becoming like video games now. Fucking mobile ads, I mean.
Harris laid it off for Kovacevic.
They'd be just appearing on your screen.
Long pass ahead at center. Grab by Todd.
Like, bro, fuck off.
Here's Suzuki, dropping it back for Caulfield. It's Suzuki to Cole Caulfield, and front off with a shot stopped by Talbot. Broussard will gain the red line, and he'll top it in with 3 minutes to go in the first. Kovacevic waits back of his own net. Former Ottawa junior senator and Hawkesbury Hawk will skate it out. Get it up to the red line and dump it in. And that one went off referee Cody Beach. Parker Kelly up with it. Lays it up for Gambrell. Got it in deep. Jack Eye after it for Wyman. He's bumped. Throwing it in front. Fires, and that goes wide on the setup from Kastelic. Hoffman through center for Wyman. Out dumped in. And that one got away from Hoffman. Dylan Gambrell up for Kastelic. He'll gain the Canadiens line. Kastelic shoots right on. Puts him over the stop of the
puck. Oh my.
Back to him, and he'll cover it up and hold
on.
Download the app and see for yourself why Bet365 is the world's favorite sports.
Whoa. Don't be advertising that shit on my stream.
How about Gooley cooling going down here twice? You got to watch the back pass from Kachuk to DeBrincat, and you don't want to be standing up, creating all kinds of holes through your body. So he goes down quickly on the ice, and then he has a nice block later on in this penalty kill. Real solid year so far for Kaden Gooley. And then down low, this line is going to be a handful all night long. Suzuki to Caulfield to Dock, and a nice save by Cam Talbot. He's had quite a few here.
Holden fires. That goes wide. Oh, shit. Off the back of it. Edmondson is on it. Lifted out as much as he... Battle up front of the forwards between these two teams is something to watch.
Ooh.
And Jake Sanderson is a storyline for both teams on the blue lines here in this one as well. There's a pass back for Pinto. Got it over to Kachuk, and a big block by Edmondson. Pinto ups it off into the corner. Cooley up the middle, went off the stick, and then Brännström get it towards the net. It was cleared out. Slavkovsky's on it. Here is Slavkovsky. Skates it into the Ottawa zone. Slavkovsky spins and tried to fire it towards the net. Went off the leg. Kicks back for Anderson to the point. Here's Harris moving to the middle with traffic in front, and that one got redirected and skipped wide.
I was just looking what.
Kovacevic trying to get it to the net. Evans got a piece of it. Ottawa clears it.
Never mind.
Knocked down by Brady Tkachuk. And the Canadiens reset in their own zone. Harris has got it. No way back of his own net. There comes Harris.
Ooh, they actually said in French. Wow. What they said less than 1 minute in the period in French. Moi de 1 minute de la période.
To the point, Kovacevic keeps it in.
Right. One time I tried streaming in French and the chat was just weird.
We'll feed it back across as Kovacevic will dump it right back in. Talbot will move it this time. There's Edmondson.
And I'm like, okay, well, that's lost on my streaming in French.
Feeds it over to Cooley. Get the one timer on net. Cooley check back of the goal by Kastelic. Tries to hold it down low, waits for a little help. It comes
a ton. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well, I found it entertaining. Nice. Alrighty.
I forgot to turn this off. I put it on the screen just so I don't forget. Alrighty, so in the first period, no goals. And then we got 10 shots for Montreal, 5, 4, Ottawa, then power plays. No one got a goal, and that's a 0% move. Face-off percentage is 54% Montreal, 46% Ottawa. Block shots is 5 Montreal, 6 Ottawa. Takeaways, none. Giveaways, they're tied at 4. I can't say what I always say about, like, about the team with the more giveaways. It's 19 Ottawa, 8 Montreal. There's penalties, and the penalties were Shabbat roughing Caulfield, and then Jack A roughing Kastelic. Well, anyways, we'll be back.
Yo, I am back. Nothing yet on there, but I just got the notification about the game starting. Oh, did the thing go down? Let's check. Damn, the last stream was like December 1st on Twitch. It's like my second stream of December. Alright, I guess fix this up real quick. Yellow. Hello, game.
Good skater. He has good hands. I mean, Marty St. Louis had him on the second power play unit. I mean, he's out at important times.
There you go. Yeah. Put a jack eye on that.
He's got some good skill sets. I think it's been a real great surprise.
Hoffman had the puck go off his foot. It ends up in a turnover. And the breaking shot's off the stick of Montemone out of play.
Senators had some, really had five shots in the first period. But at the end of the day, they had some really good looks. And they just didn't hit the net. I mean, from that one there is from far, I get that one, but this one in tight, missed the
net. Alrighty, come on.
Pulls it across right into the middle, misses the net. I mean, constantly here, you keep missing these opportunities, and there's just a whiff by Giroux. I mean, those are shots from high real estate spots in the ice where you get good quality scoring chances. They've got to start to hit the net.
Broussard tossed out of the draw. Kachuk comes in to take it against Nick Suzuki. Won it onto the board. Sanderson will poke it free for Broussard. Dumped off back to the net. Brady Kachuk trying to center in front. Pull Giroux at the side of the goal. Will get a piece of it. Now Kachuk tangled up with Caden Gooley. Caulfield sends it over to top. Sanderson in his way and they can't get it out. Now they will. And Joel Edmonds.
Is my graphic coming back or has it died?
Hammond left it in the corner. Broussard up the boards and Brady Kachuk. Battle his way to center court. Kachuk with four hits in the first period. And now he's got a chance in front, and he had to go off his stick. Giroux picks it up off the glass. Snapped off the goal post by Pinto.
Here's oh, he's just freaking decided.
Great pass for Pinto.
Ooh. No bad.
Now it's Caulfield after it. He'll throw it off the outside of the net. Kirby Dock trying to get a handle on the puck. Shabbat is there to break it. Feeds it back.
Oh, shotgun. You got it spoiled.
Pinto again. He'll shoot and score.
Seconds delayed.
Shane Pinto didn't miss that one. He snaps a six-game goalless drought, and Ottawa is on the board first. Heard the guys in the studio talking about Shane Pinto, how he tracks pucks, gets on pucks, goes to the scoring areas. That one goes off the post, chance one. How about chance two, right in front, backhander, great save by Montembeau. And then, you know what, third time's a charm.
Pinto
goes down his offside and snaps it far side on Montembeau, just inside the post and in. If you don't succeed, try again.
Bad.
Shane Pinto, just as the crowd was starting to cheer Kohan's goal, he puts it in the back of the net. Sens take a 1-0 lead. Pinto with his 10th of the year. Alex DeBrincat extending his point streak to 7 games on the assist. There's Jack Eye in his own end, being watched by Castlevik. He'll feed it up for Slavkovsky.
Oh, we did go offline, so see you in the VOD. I'm recording right now, so yeah. Just don't want to freaking completely spam everyone with that disc, that stream starting.
A couple of inches away from being one heck of a collision. Watch the miss right there as he picks his head up. Austin Watson coming up, had him drawn, and just didn't catch him in the right spot, but good job by Slavkovsky.
All right, we're just recording now.
Shabbat throws it in front, and everyone trying to find it. Batherson does, knocked down by Wyman. Penalty coming up here as Wyman will go to the box for tripping.
It was a real good period for the Montreal Canadiens. You're on the road, you're in Ottawa. I thought they took it to the Senators for a good portion of the period, that the better scoring chances, Ottawa missing the net too much. And then you start this period and you give up three good chances to the same guy who eventually buries the third one. And then you take a penalty behind the net, Weidman on Batherson, and not a good start here.
Yep.
In the first 2 minutes and 40 seconds.
This is where our hopes and dreams go to die.
Sharp power play. Put it to work here early.
That's how it happens, man. I'm used to this.
Edmondson has got it. He'll stop, backhand it off the glass, and get it out.
Well, it's the one thing, if Ottawa can get that power play to keep clicking and keep it being a real positive momentum push for them in games, it can go a long way.
Here comes DeBrincat. Dropped it out for Tkachuk. Back to the point for Shabbat. Shabbat. Landed off to Giroux. Gets it back. Now to Brinkett for Shabbat. Firing. And Montembeau got a piece of it. To Brinkett for Batherson. Poked to the point. Thomas Shabbat controls it once more. Claude Giroux down and tight. Batherson in front. Can't get the feed from Tkachuk. Tkachuk moves it back in the net for DeBrincat. Tkachuk around the goal. Throws it out front.
Oh.
Batherson. DeBrincat to the point. Shabbat for Giroux. He'll tee it up and it's off a stick. DeBrincat back for Shabbat once more. Shabbat to DeBrincat. Fire.
Ooh. Nice. And the Canadians clear. Well, my prediction's already wrong. I had a 2-0 Montreal prediction.
It looked like Montreal was trying to read the pass, and they didn't go to the obvious pass. Tkachuk out to Batherson, just one to note. That was a, everyone thought that was going to Giroux.
Well, Ottawa can leapfrog over us. I don't care. The lower Montreal is in the standings, the better chance we got the Bedard. Same as Florida. The lower they get into the standing, the more chance Montreal gets the Bedard. Montreal has Florida's pick regardless. Unprotected. Awesome. It needs to be the biggest deal of all time. Imagine. Montreal ends up getting Bedard for Ben Sherrod.
Up by Kirby Dock. And now it's Austin Watson with it. Watson down the wing, flips it on net. Montembeau will feed it back to the corner. Kirby Dock sends it for Cole Caulfield. Caulfield down the wing, tried the snapshot, it was blocked. Stays with it.
Like, the Panthers GM would probably get fired if that were the case.
Broken up by Parker Kelly. Wyman at center, then knocked down by Austin Watson. Wyman pressured on the play, and then by Kelly again. Wyman now chops it over to Nick Suzuki. Kirby Dock played it in, went off the leg of Holden. Back the other way comes Drake Patterson. He'll tee it up, and he fan of a shot. Into the corner goes Sharchik. Back to the line, tights in for Shabbat. Down to Patterson in front. Sharchik, it's over the goal. Ottawa buzzing here to start this second period. And a slashing call here.
Oh my God. Rama.
The second period for Ottawa, even the fourth line came over the boards and started to apply some pressure. Shabbat on the
another penalty for Montreal.
He lets it rip. Good save by Montembeau right there as we look at the slash.
Doc, really?
By Doc right there. Doc didn't like the call. He thought that was more of a love tap. But anything that gets up and around the hands, the referees are pretty sensitive to it. And Ottawa will head back on the power play. As I mentioned, Montreal ranks 29th in penalties. This is their third one of the night. They've killed the first two. And they've killed 15 of their last 16.
Giroux on the draw. Shabbat sets it up in his usual spot. Giroux in tight. Tkachuk for the Brinkett. Montembeau scores. What a goal. Drake Batherson puts it in through his legs. 2-0 Ottawa.
All around me are familiar faces. More no face.
Well, very good on faceoffs, win the draw. He gets down to Tkachuk. And remember the video we showed you on the first power play. Caden Gooley and Edmondson were going down quickly to block that pass from Tkachuk across the ice to DeBrincat. This one, Edmondson doesn't get it. And because he doesn't get it, DeBrincat's able to.
There was no goal interference in that.
And then it gets shoved into the net.
Hopefully that's not what they're checking for.
Power play goal. Good job right from winning the face
off. They're checking for something. Okay, thank God.
Quickly getting it across to DeBrincat. And on a 50-50 puck, Batherson buries it.
Drake Batherson with his eighth of the year extends his point streak to six games.
Well, that power play run 30%, so it's been pretty hot.
Hoffman lays it back in the net. Flipped out front. Hoffman spins, trying to get it on goal. Danenov shot is blocked by Zaitsev. And Dylan Gambrell will skate it out for Ottawa. It's the Canadiens this period that have yet to record a shot on goal. As Danenov will chip it off the boards into the corner. Zaitsev trying to go back to the net. Cut off by Dvorak.
Same.
Shabbat. Got it ahead, Lucchini. Out to center, Gambrell in over the line. Oh, that redirected, and Montembeau was going to his right and had to put the leg back to the left to make the stop.
What is that overexposed camera? Shane Pinto. Holy shit. It's 2-0 on Sports. That was an overexposed camera. Y'all didn't see it, but like, it was very bright, the camera POV. Hopefully, if that is the same camera that was like just not properly wiped violence, my dude's getting like go. If I went down. Rest in peace to that Wi-Fi. Somehow the music is still going. What? You have like two bars of Wi-Fi somehow. Alrighty, everything should be good. Another penalty.
Koski will head to the penalty box in the parade of penalties by Montreal Canadiens.
2 minutes for closing his hand on a puck.
Has really turned the momentum of this game around. When you give the Senators good players an opportunity, as we'll see here, he reaches up and grabs it and skates over and drops it. It's pretty obvious. When you give the Ottawa Senators top
end players, it was like, fuck this.
Handle pucks, get opportunities. They've got some goals here. In the second period, they're out shooting the Montreal Canadiens 10-0 right now. Remember, the Canadiens got off to that great start, and they were out shooting Ottawa handily early in that first period. If not for Talbot, it would have been a lot different start. And the Senators have found their legs here in the second. Here's Shabbat on the line with it. Feeds it off for Giroux. Back for Shabbat. Thomas Shabbat to the break it. Break it. Drops it off. Batherson for to break it. Up high, Shabbat. Down low, and it's tipped off.
Oh my god, I thought that was a goal.
Shabbat.
Like the puck ended up going behind the net. And like, I don't know. It just looked bad.
Giroux fires up high, and it's stopped by Montembeau. They've certainly watched the tape on the Senators' power play, and they're really going down quickly to take apart that play that goes across the goal mouth.
Oh my god.
Around. It's been nice passing options. DeBrincat, what a nice pass he put through the skates of the Canadian defenseman Edmondson right onto the tape of Shabbat out in the high slot. You know him for his goal scoring, but he is a really good passer as well.
In on both of the Ottawa goals tonight. Now he's racing after the puck here, but Evans got to it to the point. Batherson kept it in, but off the foot of Nick Suzuki to break it over to Shabbat. Reaches for the pass, now packs up, and he'll play it off. Pulls Giroux to the line for the break it. Towards it, and that one missed. Shabbat will catch up to it. Back for Giroux.
Oh boy, they're set up. No, get back into fucking net. Montreal, stop taking freaking penalties.
And it's 3-0. It's a game of inches, and sometimes less than that. And that might be the amount of space it tipped off the toe of Thomas Chabot's stick and kept this in the zone. It was a gutsy play. He did get a piece of it. I can see it from my vantage point down here, and it tips across. And it just sets it off right here. The pass across. Oh, it was Giroux tipped it by mistake, and then it comes to the net. And right here, good job by DeBrincat to search it out.
Hello, graphics. Are you alive?
I mean, this is just a good-looking power play by the Ottawa Senators, and it looks to be the captain may have got a stick on that. But the play by Giroux out at the top of the blue line to tip that and keep it alive to DeBrincat was huge. If he doesn't get that puck, that's out of the zone. Power play's got to clear the zone.
Tanking for Bedard. Let's take for Bedard. We did agony for Slavkovsky last year. This upcoming year, it'll be. I can't think of a synonym, but it is pain for Bedard. Let's do this again.
Tipped it off for Kastelic. Worked over by Dadanoff. Kastelic up with a puck. Got it down to the side of the net. Throw it in front. Lucchini trying to reach for it. Kastelic as well. Kept in by Hamannik. And the Canadians control it as Harris.
Montreal, get a shot. Please, please.
Approaching the midway mark of the second period here. The Canadians still without a shot this period.
Well, as you know, there are a lot of Canadian fans that make that two-hour trip down the highway to be here, and they were pretty vocal early. They're pretty quiet right now. Ottawa Senators have silenced them, and second power play goal of the game for the Ottawa Senators goes to Kachuk. And again, good on DeBrincat to jump on this and keep it alive. A good power play is all about searching out pucks that get blocked that are 50-50. You jump on those quickly, and here's how good Ottawa's power play has been. 17 power play goals, first in the National Hockey League, and then even strength there. Only have 15 of them. That ranks them 30th, but the power play has been really hot of late, almost 40%.
Here's Joel Edmondson in front for Kaden Gooley, and he couldn't get a handle on it to get a shot.
All right, come on.
Edmondson throws it towards the net, deflected over the goal. Suzuki trying to dig it out. It's jammed up against the net there by Broussard. Now Kaden Gooley hands it off. Doc throws it towards the net, goes wide. Suzuki on it again. Back for Kirby Doc. Over to Kaden Gooley. Pinto and Gooley's got a race out at center to get it.
We almost had something Pinto's there.
On him and then fired into the Ottawa bench by Kaden Gooley. Everyone had to duck for cover. Ottawa bench not happy about that.
Hit the trainer. Unfortunately, he'll head to get some work done. And that puck entered the bench. And when it entered the bench, it ricocheting off the glass. And
oof. Rest in peace.
That is really unfortunate there. That's just you'll see.
Oh, they're showing the replay. Oh, yay. How about that?
Catches him right in the top of the forehead. And Luke Richardson the other night in Chicago caught one as well and had a major gash. When those pucks enter the bench, it goes by so many people that it just misses and you just don't see it.
There's Brandstrom down low. Trying to go up the boards. Anderson cut it off. Lankowski. For Anderson, dropped to the line for Eberchekai, throw towards it and tipped away. Wyman plays it off for Evans in the corner. Back to Wyman. Down for Slavkovsky. Grants from right on him, and Parker Kelly comes over and lays out Slavkovsky. Brandstrom had the wrong license plate of the truck that caught him. Now Arbor Jack guy trying to work over Shunchik. Wyman for Anderson. Back for Evans. Lost it. Brady Tkachuk is on it. Tkachuk bumped in the corner by Chakai. Throws it in front, and that pass was picked off by Evans as Broussard was parked in front of the net. Evans will leave it back for Wyman. Arbor Jackal up to Slavkovsky. Long pass, it'll bounce over to Evans. He'll knock it in deep, and Brandstrom is on it.
Well, the Senators' forecheck has really pinned Montreal down below their hash marks for a lot of this period, and that just wears you down, and just a step up from the first period for Ottawa, and the Canadiens just haven't been able to get going.
Puck goes into the Ottawa bench and out of play as the captain, Brady Tkachuk, with his goal on the deflection, makes it 3-0 Ottawa.
Oh, that's who we could have had if we didn't pick freaking Koskinen. Pain. Pure pain. Montreal, what you doing? Even the camera agreed to your pain.
Great to see that event continue as Hoffman trying to knock it off the boards, but Watson was there to cut it off. And Lucchini is checked by Edmondson. Kaden Gooley. We'll bank it off the glass and out. Knocked down at center by Sanderson. He'll fight his way back in, trying to slide it over to Lucchini on the wing. Canadiens back on it as Edmondson has got it. Over to Kaden Gooley. Into red line and dumps it in. One of the shots favoring Ottawa here in the second period. Sanderson. Pressured on the play by Dadanoff, and Jake Sanderson will take a shot with it. Slides it over for DeBrincat. Now Sanderson will wait with it. DeBrincat. Up through center. Got it across. Right back to DeBrincat.
Oh.
Feed it over to Batherson, and the play was broken up by Kovacevic. Shabbat will flip it in, and Kovacevic back on it again. Kovacevic.
All right, come on.
Off of the wing. Harris got it to the line, and that's an offside.
Bruh.
The Rogers Wrapped in Red event is
on now. You can legit watch the game for my glasses. $60 a month.
Well, DJ Smith last game lost two forwards fairly early in the first period. They were out of the lineup, Mott and Stützle, and he had to pretty much play with 10 forwards. His comment was, the NHL is not built to play a game with 10 forwards right now, and he's absolutely right. The way these guys play and the pace that they play at, the Senators got a chance to get it done. Playing with different players, you never really knew who you were going to play with.
I could have almost had it.
The Canadiens will get a power play on a great break by Jonathan Drouin.
One of the few times in this period the Montreal Canadiens have gotten a bit loose, and Jonathan Drouin, who's playing his first game at some time,
he's
going to get a clean look at this thing. Dooley bumps it up, it bounces over Holden's stick, and that catches Kelly a little bit flat-footed, and Drouin, a good skater, just takes it in and looks to go through the five hole, and I think he just doesn't get really a good piece of it. Good job by Talbot coming across and tracking it. I don't think there was enough there for a penalty shot, although the Montreal Canadiens bench was looking for
Let's see what happens here.
For 2 minutes or less, and the Montreal Canadiens down 3-0 with 6:54.
Well, Montreal.
Spark
the game. Where's fucking Gooley on this? Like, come on.
Drouin now will set it up on the blue line, hands it off for Kirby Doc. Doc feeds it over to Caulfield. Back for Drouin. He'll shoot right on, and Talbot makes the save.
We should have Gooley quarterbacking this. And then Jack Eich quarterbacking the second one.
That gives Talbot a chance to lock in, and there's Doc right across, and he has to take it from the skate. And then back to Drouin, that gives, like I said,
not the way
to track it across the middle of the ice. Slavkovsky, who is a big body, standing right in front of him, and that's what you got to do. You got to take the goalie's eyes away.
Jonathan Drouin will play it for Kirby Doc. Doc along the boards, back for Drouin. Drouin slides it over to Kosky.
Come on. Oh.
Suzuki trying to get to it, picked up Bowen clear down the ice by Derek Brassard.
Well, the one thing you know Montreal loves is they love that seam play from Suzuki through to Caulfield. And if you're Ottawa's penalty killers, I'm sure you've seen it on the tape a lot. That's the one thing they're going to want to take away.
Kirby Doc retreats inside his own line to get the puck, and he'll play it up for Drouin. Here comes Nick Suzuki with it. Lifted it over to Doc. Sent around for Caulfield. Slavkovsky for Drouin.
Okay, come on, come on. What?
Suzuki back to the point for Drouin. Nick Suzuki.
Bruh.
He can't reach it. Zaitsev has got it, and he'll clear it down the ice. Forty seconds to go in the power play. Weidman now starts out with it.
What a job. Jake Lucchini here playing on the penalty kill.
Anderson. Puts it in the corner. Puck picked up by Armia. Back to the point for Weidman. Lucchini right out on him. Hoffman off the boards to Weidman. Played it over.
Ooh, one of the players don't have their stick.
Anderson, his stick breaks.
Rest in peace, Anderson.
Got it off.
I think Gambrell just dropped it. He just lost it out of his hands.
Here's Anderson with it. Josh
Anderson. Hey, come on.
Holds up, Kelly's out of the box, back at five aside as Weidman's got it.
Anderson
broken up by Gambrell, he'll get it to center.
Fuck's sakes.
And Mike Hoffman will flip it right back in the Ottawa zone. Hoffman chopped it in front, but it comes free. Gambrell has got it. Played it off for Sanderson. Dumps it off the boards into the corner. Joel Edmondson back on it, went off the stick of DeBrincat. Aiden Gooley up the wing. Dvorak will feed it around. Edmondson is on it. He'll clear it out. Holden goes to dump it in. Went off the leg, and Evans will grab it. Jake Evans.
My nose was bleeding for a second.
Holden after the puck. Knocks it away from Evans. Brandstrom has to get away from that broken stick behind the net, and Pinto will clear it out. Here comes
Patterson. All right, come on.
Lines it up ahead, just a little too far for Brandstrom.
Momentum seems to have, like, lifted.
Will lift it into the corner. Holden goes after the puck. That was Brandstrom. watched by Pezzetta, and then Pezzetta finishes his check on Brännström and knocks him down.
I say that, but carried in on the way. And he is knocked down in the corner. Stuff is going on.
Coming up to Montreal.
Yep.
Shabbat at the line with it. Talbot on the
bruh.
Here's Brassard. Off for Claude Giroux. Threw it into the chest of Brassard. The Canadians touch it. And it will be an interference call against Kirby Doc that will put the Ottawa Senators back on the power play.
All right, let's see this. That's bullshit. He had the puck not too long ago before that. Calm down, ref. SMH. Another freaking penalty. God damn. Why am I so tired? Alrighty, let me do something real quick here. I'll be watching again.
Right now, Montreal Canadiens are just hoping to get out of this period at 3-0 and see if they can't regroup.
And the puck may have just gone out straight over the glass here. Ottawa is arguing that it should be another penalty.
Fuck off.
4 minutes there because he got two for
fuck off. Ottawa.
Sportsmanlike conduct.
Y'all are already winning 3-0. Calm down.
Slamming the gate will get you a little bit extra, but I'm sure it was not just the gate. I'm sure there were a few words prior to him getting over there. Remember, he wasn't happy with the last penalty that he took, that the referee called. He didn't like the call at all. The Senators did score on that one. He came out of the box, had some words for the referee, and then, of course, now another 4 minutes and more opportunity for the Ottawa Senators.
Shot right on. Montembeau will make the stop. He'll cover it up. Hold on. And now Kachuk will draw a crowd back in the net.
Oh, Chuck, you gotta get off the ice. Gotta get off the ice. You have your helmet off. Get the fuck off the ice.
Well, it won't take much, and poking at the goaltender certainly will do it. And Brady Kachuk's a big guy. He's got to get down around the net. That's our Yurich's bread and butter. And Montreal Canadiens doing what they got to do to box him out and get him out of the goaltender's way. And right there, the extra poke. That's what Edmondson didn't like. And all hands on deck for the Montreal Canadiens. No penalties called, and Claude Giroux will take the straw.
Remember, SMH.
The last time that set up the Kachuk power play goal.
That's dumb.
Kachuk going over to the bench to get his window cleaned. A little spit on there sometimes. Maybe not even yours.
Julio cleared all the way down the ice. Shabbat loops his own net.
4 minute fucking power play. Holy shit.
Left it for to Brinkin. Kachuk over the line. Looked it across. Giroux sets it up. Kachuk for Shabbat. Back to Claude Giroux. Giroux slides it over to Brinkin and he wires it over the net. Shabbat for Giroux. to DeBrincat again. This time goes low. Pad save made by Montembeau.
Get the fuck out of there, bud.
It is kept in by Giroux and off his leg. Batherson left it back for Shabbat. Hands it off for DeBrincat. Shabbat to DeBrincat. He'll shoot off the glove of Montembeau. Scramble in front, and Kaden Gooley's got it, and he'll carry down the ice.
Well, even though the Ottawa Senators didn't score there, there's just a lot of end zone time and a lot of time left. 2 minutes and 40 seconds. They spent predominantly most of it at Montreal's end. It is so taxing to be in your zone this much if you're Montreal.
Montembeau will ring it around the glass himself.
That's what I'm saying. On NHL games, if you're on the offensive side, you're actually wasting more energy than being on the defense, which is weird. If you're on the offense, it should be less energy because you're just really using more of your brain to figure out shit. Whereas the defenders are actively trying to move their fucking bodies so they don't get a goal in.
Harris for Kovacevic connects with Yoel Armia.
Some are even blocking the puck.
Kovacevic down into the corner.
Honestly, takes energy out of you.
Ottawa will work it out, and here comes Shane Pinto.
Less than a minute in the period.
Harris after it. Laid it up for Armia. He'll lift it high in the air, and he'll get to center. Shabbat has Pezzetta right on him. Pezzetta diving, trying to catch up to it. Now to break it is on it. Here comes Patterson.
Well, Terrell Hopkins.
For Shabbat.
Or, Shabbat. I'm watching right now.
Lays it over to Ruin. Tight Kachuk in front, and Patterson put it wide. To break it back for Shabbat. Hands it off for Giroux. Load Giroux. For Kachuk, tight to his leg. Pezzetta can't get it out. He's been out for a while here. 4 seconds left in the period. Patterson hustles after it.
All right, come on.
Back in the net as period number two will come to an end.
That is it for that. Home. Alrighty. Get that freaking advertisement shit out of there.
Alrighty, so in the second period, Ottawa scored 3 times. And which was the number one goal was by Shane Pinto. This is by DeBrincat in the sentence. Then the second goal was Rick Batherson, assisted by DeBrincat and Kachuk. And then a third goal was Brady Kachuk, assisted by DeBrincat and Batherson. Shots on goal were 3 for Montreal, 17 for Ottawa. And in the overall shots at 13 Montreal, 23 Ottawa. Team stats overall. Power plays 0-2 for Montreal. 2-6 for Ottawa, makes them 33%. Faceoff wins 39% for Montreal, 52% for Ottawa. Block shots are 9 Montreal, 10 Ottawa. Takeaways 0 for Montreal, 1 for Ottawa. Giveaways 4 for Montreal, 7 for Ottawa. Hits 20 Montreal, 27 Ottawa. Penalties are Montreal's Wyman tripping, Batson, Montreal's dog, Flash and Chipot, Montreal's Slavkowski. Closing hand on puck, I don't know what that is. Kelly, Slash and Dwayne, Montreal's dog, abusive officials, damn, he cussed him out. And dog interfering Kachuk. All right. We'll be right back.
seemingly no worse for wear. A couple of stitches, good to go.
Alright, we're back.
Hey, that thing's in his, that's his eye. That I thought it hit him on the head. I just had a chat with him and talked to him. That cut is right above the eye. That is absolutely amazing that that wasn't worse. He's very, very lucky. He's chuckling about it now. Not just the players are tough, but Dominic's one tough cat himself and took it right on the tough spot there. He's right back behind the bench. That is a very lucky.
And you know right now they're watching in the back of the dressing room. They're on the radio with him saying they're talking about you. They can see it all on national TV right now. That's what the chuckle is. I guarantee you. Well, glad he's all right, that's for sure.
I thought it
let's actually, like, come on. Graphics, please work.
And he obviously quickly, but when he came back on the eye, I was like, whoa.
Here's Giroux to the point for Shabbat. 18 seconds to go in the Ottawa power play. The break, it got it down low. Fed in front. And it's turned over.
There you go. Perfect.
You saw the shot chart there on the power play, and most of the shots are coming right out in front of Montreal. So obviously the Senators really want to attack that down low slot. They tried it up high a little bit, but now down low looking for that quick slot to Batherson or across the front to DeBrincat.
All right, let's do this. One more period.
Here comes Sanderson.
Four goals.
Dylan Gambrell.
Let's do this, Montreal.
Romasevich after the puck. Harris around the boards and out. It'll go down the ice, wide of the net, and be an icing call.
Well, the first period certainly out of the gate slow with the Ottawa Senators, and if not for Talbot, this thing could have been 2-0 for Montreal. He made a couple of real big saves early, and then the Senators kind of got their legs underneath them a little bit towards the end of the first, and boy, did they pour it on in the second. And for Marty St. Louis and his Montreal Canadiens, he's hoping for a little answer back here in the third.
Pinto back behind the net, pumped by Harris. Gambrell comes up with it to the point. Sanderson with a shot, doesn't make it through, and then it's chipped towards the goal by Pinto.
Come on.
Harris ties up Pinto in the corner. He'll break free. It's a back for Hemming. Fired in. Gambrell is after it. Left it. Harris will take it. Jordan Harris will wait back in his own net.
Well, I'm sure coming into this one, Marty St. Louis, when he was meeting with his team, was saying, look, let's stay out of the box. This is a team that's power play is running real hot right now, and they didn't listen to him because six penalties and a couple of power play goals against.
Up comes to Wyman. He'll fire the shot.
All right.
Talbot slides across and covers it.
They're starting to be hot now, Montreal, so see what happens.
Shutout is Talbot. He's looked really sharp tonight, especially early when they really needed him. In the second period, he could have put out a sleeping bag. They didn't need him much, but right there, he starts the third period with a great job tracking the puck across the front of the net. He's seeing everything right now, and when you're feeling it, the puck looks really big, and you find it no matter where it is on the ice.
Dvorak. Throws it to the point, Wyman.
All right, come on.
Words for Hoffman, down to the corner for Dvorak. Charche watches him. Dadanov, back to
Talbot
is holding a few
minutes
for Parker Kelly. Up the middle, Charche. Caught by Wyman. Jacka holds the puck and then knocks down Charche. Dvorak, long pass ahead for Hoffman. He won't catch up to that. And that's an icing call.
No. Don't be advertising shit like that. Come on. I'm trying to run an ad-free stream.
Chuck will line up against Dvorak.
The only ads I can play are my own.
Well, Giroux, that's a poor Shabbat. Can find the linesman there, and the Canadians clear it. That was a long shift that Montreal was looking to get the line change for, so they catch a break with that. Giroux to center, off the stick of Armia. Brought in by Broussard, and then thrown towards the net. It was tipped by Drouin, went on goal.
Now Giroux in front for Tkachuk off his stick. Hammer lays it back to Giroux. Shabbat to Tkachuk, firing, kicked out by Montembeau. Hammond trying to get it back to the net, off the foot of Edmondson. And Caden Gooley. A long pass ahead for Jonathan Drouin.
Go, go, go. Oh my God, that would have like undone the pass.
First goal of the season, and he catches iron. Austin Watson. Rolls it towards Montembeau, directs it to the corner. And the puck gets
through. That could have undone everything.
He's back on it.
Everything.
It's like, what do I have to do to find the twine and get that red leg to go on? It has been a struggle. 18 games, he's yet to find the
net. I'll say St. Louis, Lurie giving you every option.
Slavkovsky wires one towards the goal, steered aside by Talbot. Brännström. Got it up ahead, and it's Jacob Lucchini that'll clear it to center. Play back into the Canadian zone. Last 4 years in the American Hockey League with Wilkes-Barre, Laval, and Belleville for Jacob Lucchini.
A little tidbit for you. His father, John, played in the Little League World Series.
Back all right, come
back
on.
In 76, and one of his teammates is the next teammate of mine, a guy by the name of Ray Ferraro.
That is the Trail BC connection for the former Trail Smoke Eater.
Second baseman and a catcher, so they were connected.
Long pass. Yes.
Let's keep this momentum going.
Here's Doc up with it. Dropped it back. Intended for Caulfield. Broken up.
Not for Ottawa. Montreal. We're off.
Harris has got it. Quick story.
Yeah, they only scored once here.
Gini and the Belleville Senators were supposed to be off all week. Matt Patterson called on the icing. Supposed to have the week off, and he was going to have a school visit and a school photo today, and he made sure he texted the team, have you got me covered for today, because I've been called up to the NHL and won't be there. I respect that.
Well, there's a look at Joel Armia, who had a pretty clean look here. You'll see the Senators come into the middle, and they get caught right there on the inside on Jake Sanderson, and he looks to go forehand, backhand, and as he goes forehand, we'll see if it just kind of rolls on. Yeah, the puck kind of sits up, just starts to come off the ice, and disappointing for sure. You can't imagine that this is something when he leaves the rink, it just goes away. I mean, you think about this constantly. The one thing you want to do is be productive. You want to help your team, and in doing so, chip in the best you can. And when you're not scoring, it's you know, you really feel it. Taxing on your mind.
Here's Sanderson. Backhands it up the boards. Got it out. Dadanoff. On it in his own end. And they'll hand it off for Weidman. Weidman for Dadanoff. Through center. Got by Broussard. Slides it over onto the wing. Going after the loose puck, but it was in the feet of Hamonic. Now Dylan Gambrell will try to get it out off the stick, and it skips back as Sanderson will play it off the boards for Gambrell. At the point, it is kept in by Joel Armia. Try to work it down low for Dvorak, and Ottawa will clear it. Tkachuk hustling after it.
Good job by Hamonic to stand up. Don't sit off the front of the net. Step up, take your ice back, and he's able to get on Dvorak and chip that out of the zone.
Holden will dump it in. Montembeau plays it for Edmondson. Drouin, long feed. Caulfield trying to get there first. He won't win the race, and that's an icing call.
Even more advertisements that they're trying to break into my fucking stream. SMH.
But the inside position of the defender has the inside track, and I think it's the right call by the lines.
Pinto caught it to the point here. Zaitsev with a shot, and Batherson may have got a piece of that in front. Caden Gooley out of the way. Jonathan Drouin building speed into the Senator zone. Dropped it back, and it's cut off by Ottawa. Batherson will go back the other way. Holds off Harris. Batherson
floats a pass across. Great chance down the wing for Puccini, and he's stopped by Montembeau. Josh Anderson works it back in the Senator zone. Throws it on net. Talbot's got it. He'll hold on.
Well, Marty St. Louis flipping all his lines around now into the blender.
Jacob Luchini in his first NHL game gets a good scoring chance as the Senators are up.
Advertisement time. No, in this stream though. Not a single yet. Oh yeah, like what the heck? What do we have to, what does Montreal have to do? I'll be honest, I guess.
Seven assists in his last seven games.
His last streak of seven or more games goes all the way back to pulls out the 2021 season when he was on an eight-game streak. Devins will hand it off for Slavkovsky after a bit of a scramble around the Canadiens' net. Now he'll get it out back to the Ottawa zone. Slavkovsky lost the puck. Jake Evans on. Lays it over to Weidman. Flips it down.
Holden.
Off the boards. Pass Weidman and out. Joel Edmondson. Quick pass for Slepkovsky. He'll deflect it into the corner. Evans after the puck. Branstrom on him. Jake Evans throws it in front. And just like that, Kirby Dach has the Canadiens on the board.
There is lots of time left. Senators really trying to stand up, and Holden does a nice job of that. But the puck goes by him, and then there's a fight for the puck between Branstrom and Evans. He goes in, he wins the fight for the puck, and he gets separation from Branstrom. Watch when he turns here. He just turns it and lays it out in front, and of course, he sees him there as he goes in, and then he throws it, hoping it's going to find its way through. And as the Senators are back checking into their zone, nobody picks up number 77, Kirby Dach. And that's a defensive lapse in the Senators' zone. And the Montreal Canadiens are on the board. What a nice play by Evans.
Snaps a 14-game goalless drought for Kirby Dach. His last goal was November 9th against Vancouver. Here's Giroux trying to make a play with it. Puck came out on Hamonic out over the line. That's an offside.
Well, a one battle. I mean, they haven't won a lot of battles since early in the first period, but they win a battle on a 4-2. And they get the puck and they do good with it. I mean, yeah, it's
with my they were asking me to get delivery.
Why not? But, you got to get on the board somehow. And
I've been getting hydrated.
Battle in the corner. And you look at the
Matthew, I don't see my previous stream. You don't know what I mean.
Really, gets really in on the stick and takes that stick away.
Now Dadanoff tries to move it at his own blue line. It'll get dumped in. Montembeau will set it up for Kovacevic. Flushed out by Patterson. Harris laid it up through center. Dadanoff didn't catch the pass. DeBrincat will work it back in. Dvorak is there. Harris after it on the boards. Stopped at center by Hamannik. Now Hoffman is on it. Lays it for Dadanoff. Dadanoff. Saucer pass for Hoffman. Canadiens bringing it over the line. Dvorak got it onto the wing. Dadanoff goes after it. Kovacevic with it up high. Over Jacki with a shot goes wide. Bounced off the backboard side of the net. Dvorak was there. Couldn't get a stick on it. Jacki trying to play it away from Gambrell. Fights off Sharchik.
Alrighty, come on.
Takes it to the corner. Back to the point. That'll come to center.
Well, it's a good test for Ottawa. You've been up 3-0 for quite a while this game. You've just given up a goal. Can you get back to it? Can you get back to handling the puck, making plays, and playing in the offensive zone? Montreal's got some.
Alright, come on.
Kirby Dock beats the point.
That's all I want.
Jacki,
that's the way to say.
And it's cleared away by
He'll
connect with Caulfield.
Rolls
to the corner. Sanderson is there. Gets it off the glass. And it is moved out by
Lucio. I've never had to watch him in entertainment, so I have to think of a way to say it without sounding bad.
Watson will go to the box for tripping, and the Canadians will go to the power play after Kirby Dock has
Alrighty, well, one goal. At least we didn't get shut out. That's not bad, not bad. What is this? Oh, Scribblenauts. I remember that. Scribblenauts was some good games. You think millions of adjectives. I think that's what the word is in English. I'm having a brain fart. Synonyms. That's what it is. No. Let me search this up real quick. Now this is right. Oh no. Adjectives are is the word for an English. I don't remember many of the adjectives.
Suzuki takes a draw against Derek Brassard. Brassard won it. And it's Travis Hamannik that'll air it out all the way down the ice. Montembeau sets it up, and here comes Jonathan Drouin with it. Up to center.
Another power play. Let's see if we act just for
this time. Carries it himself. Goes after it in the corner. Sanderson on him. Puck knocked loose. Parker Kelly tried to get to it. Canadians back on it. Slavkovsky missed it. Sanderson up the boards for Gambrell. Hit by Doc. Slavkovsky. Now Doc brings it around. Caulfield is there. Cole Caulfield trying to protect it with Parker Kelly on top of him. Head to the point for Jonathan Drouin. Hands it up for Jock in front.
Come on. I'm not looking to my right monitor now. Come on.
Off the board. Back for Drouin. To talk again.
Let's actually get an effective power play here.
Caulfield will catch up to it. Cole Caulfield to the point. Drouin to Kirby Dock.
Hey, come on, let's do this.
Up high for Drouin. Back to Caulfield. He'll wait.
Fucking what? Caulfield should have done a one-timer. Fuck. Alrighty, come on. One time it. First shot. Fuck. The most fucking powerful that Montreal has ever been on the power play this night, tonight. Shut up, Sportsnet. Don't mention that. I didn't see anything.
He'll work it in. Dropped it off. Shot by Ramirez wide of the net. Anderson is on it. Josh Anderson.
That'd be a pretty cooper. We're doing a good thing. Why the fuck is never mind. Power play's over, but still. Why the fuck is Armia on the power play?
Stick goes flying. Now Armia can go get his stick as the puck just hit it. And he's on it.
Yeah, Jack Ryan fucking Gooley some time on the power play. Dumps it into the end zone. Anderson after the puck. And where's his value?
Another penalty coming to Ottawa. Havoc's gonna get
nice. Yeah, Gooley on the fucking power play.
Slides it to the point for Dvorak. Play it across.
Don't have fucking Hoffman be on there.
Tipped by Edmondson. Back to the point. Dadanoff walks the line.
Oh no.
Kenny Dadanoff.
Oh no.
Suzuki.
Somebody scored. Let's go. Let's go.
It's a one goal game.
Hey, game day. I'm like, no way. Fucking Otto scored. Fucking hell.
Well, it's not a power play goal.
One after a night.
Canadians with six attackers on the ice. The Ottawa Senators taking their second consecutive penalty.
Yeah, I don't know why that doesn't count as a power play goal. Because they're still at five. We have that bonus player anyways.
To get the right spot, boy, did he place this shot.
Like, Ottawa's not allowed to touch it, so like, it should be considered a power play goal.
Have climbed back into this game.
Alright, one more goal.
The Ottawa Senators for sure. I mean, you're looking at a team that's been on a pretty good run of late. And now with 6:48 to go, just a one goal lead. Six of the year for Christian Dvorak. Strap yourselves in. We might have a big finish here in Ottawa.
Don't jinx it, please.
And here comes Jonathan. With a shot that goes wide. He's after his own rebound. Set free along the goal line. Brady Tkachuk has got it. He'll clear it out. Bo Giroux can't get it by Edmondson at center. Drouin will come up with it. He'll lift it in. Talbot out of the net to stop it.
Go Habs, yo.
Savage played it in front. Nobody there to get to it. Harris for Nick Suzuki.
All right, come on.
Back to Kovacevic. He'll curl. Harris off for Doc. Missed the pass. Has to hustle. Shane Pinto coming in. Right
all right, caution, wake up.
Quick backhand pass across.
Wake up, caution.
Suzuki left it for Kirby Dock. Hooked off this.
Get my man another goal.
Harris is back first. Kovacevic up to center.
Get that emote going too.
Suzuki will hand it off.
I haven't used that Cole Caulfield emote in a while.
Just skate, dump it in. You got nobody going. Get a change, throw it back, get some fresh bodies on the ice. Dadanoff throws it in front, but off the foot of Lucchini. Here's Dvorak. Dadanoff for Dvorak, firing a Talbot, got it with his arm. wrapped up the boards by Shabbat down the ice, and this will be waved off.
Down.
So Jacki will take it.
SMH.
Lays it up through center. Nick Holden's there to stop it. Claude Giroux.
No. Bouncing puck popped off.
Cleared out, holding on it again. And that is blowing
down. We got ourselves a game now. Woo!
Christian
Dvorak. It's more exciting now.
It's 3-2.
No longer tired. We need some hype music now. What? Let's just get some of the greatest hype songs ever. We got a game, so this part's probably not going to be cut off. This is probably going to get cut off because of copyright. Don't care.
Keep my circle tight, yeah. All my hoes, yeah. Keep that sugar spice, yeah. For
the
and then Nick Suzuki with a nice little backhand pass to Dvorak. He buries it top shelf. That was on a delayed penalty to Ottawa. So they had six guys on the ice, and with 4:33 to go, this is going to be a tight one to finish. Brady Tkachuk skated over the bench during the commercial break, and he yelled at the bench. He's like, guys, we're fine. We're fine here. So he's just reminding the guys that, hey, we're going to play in these tight games. We're going to cut them out.
Edmondson on the dump in had his stick.
All right, come on.
To get a new one as Sanderson will throw it up for Giroux at center. Diving for it. Now he's got it back. Well, Giroux will send it to the corner. Edmondson after it. Broussard right on him. Getting Gouley up with it. Gouley trying to get it out. Blocked by Tkachuk, and he'll keep it in deep. Edmondson. In the corner in a battle with Broussard. Now Kanan Gouley has got it. Edmondson dropped that second.
Oh,
stick.
What? Oh, what?
Down at center.
Anderson is saying it went off his back and went to his teammate. They're saying it's a hand pass, so they're going to blow it down in the neutral zone. It was a high flipper that Anderson didn't really locate. And there you see Gouley launch it up into the air. And as it comes down, I think it hits him in the side of the arm, right at the numbers. So
hit him in the elbow.
Yeah, it wasn't a hand pass. Calm the fuck down, refs. But the fuck.
That's, line's been deemed that a hand pass, and they drop it in this neutral zone, and away we go.
Harris, long pass, trying to connect up with Nick Suzuki. Kirby Dach will follow up with it. Got it in over the line. Suzuki swiped at it, trying to feed it for Caulfield. DeBrinket will take it back. Alex DeBrinket to center, rings it into the Montreal zone. Suzuki after it, it's grabbed by Anderson. Plays it across.
Montreal.
It'll go against the Canadiens as Kovacevic will touch the puck.
Fucking
call will give Ottawa
the camera.
Well, I mentioned these both these teams take a lot of penalties, and I think something like we're going to see a lot more of these tonight, and we have. And we've seen a plethora of penalties for both these teams, and what a great play by Batherson over here. Just take some of the pressure off, make Montembeau have to move a little more, and Broussard tries to get it through here, back to Batherson, and there's the penalty on the play right there. Marty St. Louis doesn't like the call. He thinks it's a bit soft. It didn't look like much, I'll tell you that.
Oh, fuck it. Here we go.
Struck twice tonight. Well, Giroux will take the faceoff against Christian Dvorak.
Well, this is when you need it the most. I mean, you had a lead, you lost it. Now you can secure it back again if your power play can bury one.
Oh, that's a boy.
It's clear down the ice. Talbot's got it. He'll set it.
Kill that penalty. Kill that penalty. Oh, Jesus! Goals, boys! Fucking, of course I'm here there. Fucking hell. Get fucking Armia off the puck and get fucking Suzuki, Caulfield, and Doc, Swap, Anderson. Fucking. Girls. Get our fucking top six on this.
Thomas Chabot over to Claude Giroux.
Dvorak has his goal.
For Chabot to the break it. Down low.
I don't give a fuck.
For Giroux. Up high to Chabot.
The goal is to fucking score.
Patterson flipped it on net and it's stopped by Montebeau. Covers it up.
Regardless of the cost. I can get Jack Benefit Kachuk here.
Front, Arbor Jack guy, and
oh, yes. Nice.
And Kachuk ends up down on the ice, and Ottawa finally gets the puck into the zone. They get some good puck movement. We've seen
all
some
right, let's see the Kachuk versus Jack guy action here.
Crisp and clean. Batherson looks across to Giroux, and as it comes back to Batherson this time around, he's going to look for a hole to throw it through. But Montebeau does a really nice job of hugging his post.
Oh, Edmondson. Oh, no, never mind, Jack Edmondson. Come on, let them fucking fight. Whoa, he fucking shove him onto the ground.
Ottawa's going to take their time out here and get a rest of their guys. I mean, it's a important juncture of the game. 57 seconds.
All right, come on. Let's just get fucking Montreal. Put all your fucking top guys here.
They can't find a power play goal here late in the game.
You don't know what to do.
We got 57 seconds here to gut this out, kill this penalty, and then we're going to have some time to tie this thing up. But first things first, let's get this penalty killed.
No more penalties, Montreal. No more penalties. Is that a bearded fucking siren?
Loves it. The mixed fan base, a full house here in Ottawa tonight.
Bearded siren.
They have been treated to an entertaining contest so far.
It's been some major momentum swings. Really early to Montreal, and then the second period was
all right. Fucking.
Was really taken over a lot. Third period here.
There's a lot of battle for bragging rights in the stands tonight. Opposing sweaters side by side. Here comes Batherson. Up to center and he'll dump it in. Edmondson is after it. He's met by Claude Giroux. Half a minute to go on the Ottawa power play. The Chuck tried to dig it up. Giroux along the board. Back to the point.
There you go. Alright, get the fucking top unit out, boys.
You'll get one more crack at this on the rush.
Basically, cook her up.
Montreal is exactly what they got to do. Get that kill in place. They've got
get Groove, so he's ready to go. Edmondson, Zuki, Caulfield, Doc.
Sanderson over the line for Pinto. Into the corner for Sanderson. Cole Savage goes right after him. Josh Anderson.
Get her in. The fucking you go.
Throw it on net. By Versailles and kicked out by Montebeau. Here's Harris. He'll get it up for Josh Anderson. Offside, though, at the Ottawa line. So he's got a clear. Pinto takes his time with it. Under a minute.
All right, Doug Crawford, Zuki, go.
And the Senators here have iced the puck.
All right, this is the time. Fucking cold.
Because the Canadians were offside.
The timeout. They
were trying to vacate the zone with the puck. Pinto took it back into their end. And he forced Montreal Canadiens to have to empty the zone out. As you see the collision there that sent Anderson to the ice, and then on the pass up the ice, unfortunately, the
top line out, come on.
And now Montebeau will head to the bench.
51.9 seconds to go on the faceoff to the right.
All right, keep Anderson on the ice here.
Dvorak against Pinto.
And
another icing call against Ottawa. Well, back in the day, this thing was so frowned upon, but now coaches encourage us, if you can get the net and you can get a clean look at it, then take a look at it and bury it. And that's exactly what Sanderson does. He had a real good look at it. He didn't miss it by much. And now the Montreal Canadiens will take their time.
All right, just fuck in the center of the
another foot and a half to the left, and this thing would be all about being about over for the Montreal Canadiens. The other break you sometimes get with a
name?
Off a quick whistle when you're stuck. What's
the coach name?
Change. It is a little
Alex Burr,
for the empty net.
Well, get no this he right up and good play in here.
I mean, he comes around the net. He could have went up the wall to the winger. He had that available to him. It was there.
Make this
he just
effective.
Made the choice to go for the net. And I think, like I said, it's encouraged. I think a lot of teams will rather have their team take a shot at the
Guri
net.
Edmondson,
feeling comfortable about
Doc, Suzuki, Caulfield, and Anderson. Who needs to be on the ice for now? You could easily swap Anderson with
Broussard in case Pinto gets thrown out. Dvorak against Pinto.
Alright, fucking get her done. Zuki, get ready to set Caulfield up. Alright, Doc, even better. Why the fuck does Dvorak on the ice?
Well, I really thought we'd see Giroux come out to take that draw.
Yeah, Goulin, fucking Edmondson.
Hamonic doesn't get a piece of it, and all of a sudden Montreal's got it on the side.
And we're
docking up high to where we saw Dvorak score from earlier. And that time,
I got spoiled.
Hands it off for Caulfield. It's free back to the net. Suzuki.
Come on!
Comes to the point, kept in by Drouin. 18 seconds to go.
I hate this. My fucking graphic ruined it for me. Alright, that's it.
He'll hustle back after it in front of the empty net. Clears it away for Caulfield. 4 seconds to go. Taken by Doc. The Ottawa Senators will win it 3-2.
Fucking my graphics. My graphics ruined it. There's some pepperoni that have, they fucking lost. We got 24 shots on goal. Ottawa got 31. Faceoff percentage was 49%. Montreal 51%. Ottawa power play. They needed 2-1, but they got one on like the extra man before the power play. 2-3-7 for Ottawa. 29 hits for Montreal. Ottawa 33 blocks. 12 from Ottawa, giveaways, 5 Montreal, 11 Ottawa, and rest in peace my logic. This period we had 2 goals from Montreal, they almost pulled their comeback, which was Doc and Dvorak, and Doc's goal was assisted by Evans and Sapkowski, Dvorak's goal was assisted by Suzuki and Dardanov. Penalties of the period was Ottawa's Watson tripping Weidman and Montreal's Harris hooking back to them. Shot on goal this period was 12 Montreal and 9 Ottawa. And that is it for today. Thank y'all for watching and I'll see y'all next time. Always stay safe by a helmet.